A Daytona Beach firefighter who was arrested Tuesday for rape is expected to turn himself in today after a second victim has come forward.
The new details are explosive, including word that the first victim is now being harassed and intimidated. West 2's Claire Matz joins us live from the fire station where suspect Adam Silva works. Claire?
Yeah, Martha, this is the station, the main station in downtown Daytona Beach. But effective today with this second felony arrest for a sex crime, Silva is now suspended without pay. And yes, the details of this new second case are very chilling. Meantime, we've learned that the first victim is being harassed.
In 23 years of police work, I have never seen anything as despicable and disgusting as is being done in this case right now.
Chief Mike Chitwood is red hot over what he calls witness intimidation. Hours after police got a warrant to arrest firefighter Adam Silva for a second time this week because a second victim came forward, Chief says friends of the first victim got alarming phone calls. The first victim lost her purse and cell phone that night. Police think someone found it and is using it to try and get to Silva's accuser. The chief thinks Silva's band of brothers are circling.
I believe it's a firefighter, because who would know when he has an impeccable record and you're smearing his good name, and now we're going to smear you.
Police say the first victim, an out-of-state woman who met Silva in a beachside bar May 19th, was raped in a parking lot miles away and dumped there half-naked. According to this new report, the second victim, an acquaintance of Silva's, says he came to her house later the same night and tried to force himself on her.
She thought she was going to be raped, in her own words. She thought she was going to be raped and killed. Is how out of control she describes him.
The second victim managed to fight him off. We went by Silva's home, where two unidentified men told us where to go in a hurry. And no one from the fire department will speak about this. Chitwood says if he finds out who is harassing at least one victim, woe be unto them.
I swear on the souls of my children, we will come after them with everything that we have.
Now, police say a third woman actually called them, saying she had seen Silva's computer and that he had kind of a conquest list, one that she called very disturbing on the computer. Police actually seized a computer from the fire station overnight. They also took evidence from his home. Again, we've been told by his attorney that he turned himself into the courthouse, but he has to go to the branch jail in order to bond out. A judge set $5,000 bond on this second charge. Reporting live in Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.